Baby, you were the love of my life.
I don't think I'm gonna cry today. I think I'm gonna be okay. Is this gonna make me wanna take my clothes off?
That's not normal. And I think, you know, you should maybe get some help.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. I don't think I can even do my regular intro for this video. I am overwhelmed. You have heard Harry's new album. I currently have not, which is a very weird thing to feel. It came out last night at midnight for us, but you guys had been asking me if I would react to it, and I thought it would be really fun, but it is so weird knowing that all of you have heard these songs and I have not. I'm so scared. I've got my pleasing on, the rings on, the cardigan on. It's all happening. So I've been trying to keep clear of absolutely any spoilers or any sort of publications about the album. I just wanted to go in fully, no knowledge, blank slate, head empty, no note, car gone. But I did see one thing where someone said to a journalist that has heard the album, oh, is this his 1989? And the person was like, no, it's his Red. And that scared me a little bit. If this album is gonna be as like emo, and by emo I mean emotional, as heartfelt as I'm expecting it to be, I thought I might need some of this. So this video is not monetized, so I thought, let's have a drink. Cheers. I'm about to press play, but just before I do, I wanted to say a really big thank you to you guys, basically for letting me feel like I can be my truest, fullest self on here on this channel, because I have always been someone that gets very excited about things, and I've always loved pop culture and music and movies. And so it's kind of crazy that it took me until, you know, just recent years to start talking about those things on YouTube and making videos about them. And it's just been so beautiful seeing the reaction from you guys, reading your comments, reading your DMs. I just feel so accepted, and I feel like I love being outwardly excited and expressing my enthusiasm for things, and I love when other people do that as well. And I know a lot of people think that's really uncool. Taylor spoke about it in her NYU acceptance speech. That got me super emotional, but there are so many people that try to stop you from being outwardly excited about things and roll their eyes. I just feel like in life, one of the few things we get to keep from our childhood, if we're lucky, is that sort of sense of wonder and excitement about the world. And if you can hold on to that, I think that's a real gift. And I'm doing my best to do that. So thank you guys for accepting me and loving me the way that I am, because I really love doing this stuff and chatting with all of you about it. And I wouldn't be doing it if not for you. So thank you. People are gonna be negative no matter what and judge you no matter what, but just don't let anyone dim that light, because it is just what makes life so fun. Also, I just wanna say, I was going to wear this t-shirt today. I had planned to wear it for the video, but you wouldn't really be able to see it all. But I do wanna shout them out because I love this company and I know you guys will too. This is one of my most prized possessions. So if you would like to get one of these, I'll leave a link down below. All right, are we ready? Why am I nervous? Music for a sushi restaurant, here we go. I'm gonna be honest, I was worried there was gonna be no like upbeat bops on this album. I'm kind of expecting a more mellow album, which is totally fine. Love that for him, love that for me. But I wanna shake my ass to this, so I'm so happy. You're telling me the first words of this album were green eyes? Interesting. I do need to get the lyrics up for this because I can't understand a word he's saying. Green eyes, fried rice, I could cook an egg on you. I was hoping the fruit man would involve food of some sort. So good to know we've already got it in the first two lines. He just said, I don't want you to go broke. Mate, I bought tickets to three of your shows in February. I am broke and it's your fault, Harry. I love you, babe. Just a little taste. I don't have words for this. This music is so fucking good. 1 minute and 24 seconds into Harry's house, and I'm so happy. I need to play that again. Scatting for us just now. And did anyone else think of Andy from The Office? One thing I do know is how Harry's been like, this album's the most me, and I'm like, okay, so I'm gathering. Harry's always wanted to scat, and in One Direction they were like, look, we know you wanted to put some of your little Scooby Doobies on Olivia, but it didn't really fit. Save that for your solo projects. I'm sorry, I can't get over it, it's so good. Harry, thank you for blessing my ear holes, our ear holes, and our hearts with whatever the fuck that was. I said this in my Red video, I'm gonna say it again. I can't wait to listen to this for the rest of my life. Forget Harry's house, it is Harry's world, and we're just lucky enough to be living in it. All right, next up is Late Night Talking. I haven't listened to this since the Coachella performance. My memories erased it, I don't remember a single thing. I'm going in fresh. Let's go. I do just need to say, when I heard this at Coachella for the first time, my immediate reaction was, it sounds so much like, not Dua Lipa, but the band that was trying to sue Dua Lipa. I've had too much wine. But the band that was trying to sue Dua Lipa for copyright. Words are really hard at the moment because their song sounded familiar. Late Night Talking kind of reminds me of that. We'll do a side by side. I got you. Where is Bishopsgate? Bishopsgate contains large offices for companies such as Salesforce. Okay. Why does Genius link to a random company? I mean, we know Harry lives in both of those places. I wonder if that's also kind of about his relation. We've been doing all this late night talking. One thing I really love most about Harry's music is the ability to transport us to what feels like another time. I feel like debut, I can't call it that. I feel like Harry Styles, HS1, felt like sort of an ode to the rock, soft rock artist that maybe had inspired him. And we saw a glimpse of what he'd always wanted to create whilst he was in the band. And I feel like Fine Line was even more of that, even more an expression of sort of creativity, expression of himself, and just trying new things, really kind of pushing the boundaries of music we'd heard from him before. And we got so many 70s vibes from Fine Line, and oh, rainbow lights are out. Gay rights, everyone. Anyway, I love this bitch. I just feel like if there are fans of Harry that are younger or maybe haven't listened to, you know, artists from a previous time like Stevie Nicks or Fleetwood Mac or James Taylor or any of these artists that we know that have a different sound from a different time, I think Harry is kind of a gateway drug to experience them, and falling in love with his music can help them discover those artists. So fantastic. Great work, sir. Why does this also kind of sound like a Christmas song? Like, not a Christmas song, but if we're watching like a 90s Nora Ephron or Nancy Meyers movie, this is at the end of the movie when like the families are all together, like maybe the holiday when they're all together. I can hear this song playing 100%. Everyone's like in winter nice dresses, but like wintry velvets. Velvets, I see it. Also kind of like 80s synth vibes, which I love. Can't get you off my mind. Can't get you off from all this late night talking. Sorry? Talking. Can't get you off from all this late night talking. I just want to put this here and listen to it as if he's in my head. Oh my god, his voice has grown so much. Am I gonna put in a video where he was really nervous? Yeah, I think I am. When you smile like the ground, it ain't hard to tell. You don't know your beauty. Okay, next up is grape juice, which, I mean, the man loves fruit. We know this. At this point, I'm surprised he hasn't written a song about the peach from Call Me By Your Name. Everybody, this is grape juice.
1, 2, 3.
Is this gonna make me want to take my clothes off? We're starting that again.
1, 2, 3.
I just need to sort of take a moment because I know this song is about to change my life. This has Kiwi medicine energy.
Oh, you're so cute when you're wrong.
I'm 1 second in and I know this song is gonna destroy me. Also, did he perform medicine at Coachella or was that a fever dream? Did I make that up? He definitely did, right? Okay. I love the effect that's going on. It's kind of like, you know, it's a voicemail sound effect almost. It's like distant. But can this bitch enunciate? I'm trying to sing along. It is so hard to listen to a song that you don't know the words to yet. I don't want to cheat. I don't want to read them all. But like, okay, come on, Harry. Enunciate. Is this about wine? Something old and red? I mean, mine's pink, but still. There's just no getting through. Drinking wine was a good idea today. I'm like, I didn't just have this. I was about to get ready to film this video and I was like, no, I just feel like I need to get a bottle of wine. We went to the store, asked for the sweetest rosé they had. We knew, we got it. Yes. If I can say one thing about this song, it's vibes. This is a vibey song. I just need to check real quick what year the wine from the Parent Trap was. Where dreams have no end. Harry can't own it because Nick Parker owns every bottle ever made. Damn it, the wine's from 1987 apparently. Never mind. It's just incredible watching him grow personally and musically and lyrically. I mean, obviously he's just grown up, but it just feels so mature and intimate, I guess. Like there's something about a relationship where it's not about going out and like living while we're young and getting drunk or whatever. This is a different kind of relationship to have with someone where you feel like you're just so comfortable that you would rather be at home sharing a bottle of wine and just talking. And I mean, I think it's very clear from like Harry's interviews and things like that. He's in sort of that stage of his life. He's very relaxed and very, I don't know, I just I would love to split a bottle with this guy and have some chats about life. And I wonder also if his relationship with alcohol has changed over time with sort of when you transition to the point of having like wine, it's more about late night talking and conversation and, you know, groups of friends in a quiet, intimate space. And that kind of feels like the change of his music, like from these three albums, it kind of feels like growing up, I guess. That's just really cool.
Come on, Harry, we want to say goodnight to you.
It's giving Gorgeous from Gorgeous by Taylor Swift. Gravity's holding me back. Do you know how satisfying it is to finally have one song in this album I can sing along to? Because I know the damn words. You guys obviously have heard the songs before, so while I'm sitting here vibing, learning them, let's have a chat in the comments. Share your thoughts. I want to hear your faves, your least faves, your theories. We know it's not the same as it was. As it was. Answer the phone. Harry, you're no good alone. In this world, it's just us. You know it's not the same.
Margaret Chan would like me to have some water right now.
I
Chen would want me to have some water right now.
From Memory, As It was the last song written for this album, which I love. I feel like that happens so often. The song that gets added sort of to the tail right at the end ends up being like the lead single or the, you know, the big hit. And this is no exception. I really think Harry, unlike some people, not naming names, but is very good at picking lead singles or has a team that's good at picking lead singles. Speaking of which, we're now up to track 5 and I'm like, oh my God, track 5. Thinking like that every other artist does track 5 in a specific way. But here's the thing, track 5 is called Daylight. And I know it's a coincidence, but like, let me have this. Let me have this song. That does not sound like a Harry Styles song, aka anything we've ever heard from him before. Say, I'm on the roof, you're in your aeroplane seat. Does that mean like she's high? Looking for life out there. I was nosebleeding? Is he talking about? Reading your horoscope. You were just on coke in my kitchen. Okay. You never listen. I hope you're missing me. I love that sound, whatever that little melody is. Is that a melody? I don't know, but it sounds cool. If I was a bluebird, I would fly to you. You'd be the spoon if you were naughty, so I could be sticking to you. Why is that so sweet? If I was a bluebird, I would fly to you. You'll be the spoon, dip you in honey, so I could be sticking to you. You got me close in the daylight. Like a song from a different artist. I cannot believe this is a song with Harry Styles' name on it. You got the antidote, I'll take one to go. You've got the antidote, I'll take one to go, please. I think we all know what that sounds like. Well, okay, that makes me think of 3 things. Loving you is the antidote, choose your words because there's no antidote, and here to take my medicine. Take my medicine. I would fly to you, feeling naughty, so I could be sticking to you. I love that song. He's a rock god. Next up we have Little Freak. Now people ask, is it embarrassing to have a song written about you? And I say no. So let's listen to it. Little Freak, Jezebel. Starry haze, crystal ball. Wet dream just dangling. I'm gonna need a minute. It really is not a family show anymore. If any of you are wearing headphones, I just want to do something for you real quick. Why is a song so beautiful called Little Freak? I'm not worried where you are, who you'll go home to. I'm just thinking about you. I feel like that's a really beautiful way to reflect on a past relationship. You're not thinking about them in jealousy. You're not projecting any sort of negative energy onto them moving on. You're just thinking of them. Did you dress up for Halloween? I spilled beer on your friend. I'm not sorry. A golf swing and a trampoline. Golf swing. Is this song about Niall? Tracksuit and a ponytail. You hide the body, all that yoga gave you. Wow. I want to get back into yoga. Thinking about you. I feel like most artists would have named this song Thinking About You or Just Thinking About You. He names it Little Freak. A broken ankle, karma rules. You never saw my birth mark. Broken ankle, karma rules. He said karma is real. But can we talk about You Never Saw My Birthmark for a second? Because both literally and metaphorically, that is such a beautiful line. Like if he means it literally, of course, it's kind of like, well, we never got to that stage. Like as much as we felt for each other, we never reached that point because you never saw my birthmark. And then again, emotionally, it's like we were never that close. You never saw the scars that I carry with me. You didn't see that side of me. And now I'm just reflecting on like relationships where you maybe fall really hard, really fast, even when you're not even together. It's just someone you have feelings for and never have the chance to get close to, and never have the chance to see their scars or their birthmarks. I've talked about this in a Girl Talk video, but like the hardest people to get over are the ones that you never date because you never see their flaws. And I'm not saying birthmarks are flaws, but it kind of reminds me of that, of how when you don't get that close to someone, it's a lot easier to always romanticize it because you've not seen their imperfections or, you know, the things they hide from the rest of the world. Maybe he shielded sort of that part of himself. Maybe he was closed off. Maybe he just didn't feel enough like himself to be that open yet. Birthmark could really mean a lot of things. Just thinking about you. Whole song reminded me of the line in Baby Honey where he's like, and I swear I'm not thinking about you all the time, just today, yesterday, every day, and tomorrow night, which is one of my favorite lines he's ever written, to be honest. Wow. I mean, track 5 never disappoints. And hey, I'm not crying yet. Next we have Matilda.
Honey, you've got a big storm coming.
Do you tie up your hair and you smile like it's no big deal?
Why did that just give me the visual image of actual Matilda from the movie with her ribbon doing her hair up? Is this about Matilda Wormwood?
You can let it go. You can throw a party full of everyone you know. You don't have to be sorry for leaving and growing up. Matilda, you talk of the pain like it's all alright. But I know that you feel like a piece of you's dead inside. You showed me a power that is strong enough to bring sun to the darkest day. It's none of my business, but it's just been on my mind.
I feel like I'm not ready for this bridge. Screw you guys for not warning me.
All this alone, way to go. Have to be sorry for doing it on your own. You can start a family who will always show you love. You don't have to be sorry, no.
I thought I wasn't gonna cry. I just want to talk about a few lines in that song. It's none of my business, but it's just been on my mind. I feel like that is so powerful to say to someone or to hear from someone if you are in a situation that isn't necessarily safe. To hear from someone, I know it's none of my business, but you've just been on my mind and I just want to reach out to you. I don't know why I'm going on this tangent, but it's so hard seeing someone you love be in a situation where they aren't happy or safe or taken care of or receiving the love they deserve. And that can be in any, you know, variety of ways. But I think he's just said it exactly right. Like, it's none of my business, but you've been on my mind and I just want to check in. And that feels like what this song is. It feels like checking in with someone you love and wanting them to know that they deserve better and they deserve love. I mean... Firstly, I'm crying because Matilda is one of my favorite movies, and when I saw the track list and the name, I of course thought of that, but I didn't think he would actually have taken inspiration from that, which it feels like he really has. But secondly, I'm also crying because I just feel like this song is such a love letter to people who are in families that don't understand them and don't accept them and don't love them for who they are or who they love or who they feel like. And this song is saying it's okay and you will find the people that do love you and you can start a family who will always show you love. That has so many meanings, whether that is having your own children and starting a new generation in that sense, but also chosen family and friendships and the people you surround yourself with and just the reminder of how many good people there are in the world and how many people there are that will love you. I feel like this song is gonna change lives and save lives. Am I being stupid? That's, I don't know. I really love it. Now that I've cried my makeup off, let's listen to Cinema.
You got the cinema.
This bitch, he has pulled a All Too Well to 22 whiplash experience. He said, everyone, stop crying. It's time to dance. So let's dance.
It's you. It's
checked the lyrics. He did just say that. I'm just gonna need a minute. Oh, oh. Yes. Yeah. You're sleeping in this bed. He's really gonna give us the saddest song on the album and then the horniest. Okay. Is that a Carole King song? Something in the way you move? Something in the way she moves? James Taylor? My brain can't think of anything right now except this song. I like it when you dance for me. Harry, if you like the way I dance for you, just watch this video, honestly. You got the cinema, I bring the pop to the cinema. Okay, this could be an absolute reach, but obviously she makes movies, she stars in movies, she directs movies. He brings the pop, he's a singer, he's a pop singer. Harry, while we're speaking about cinema, I need to get this across. I need you to do movie musicals. I need you to be in a Hairspray-esque movie. I don't think anyone should remake Hairspray because it was perfect, but like imagine Harry in like a Link Larkin role or a Corny Collins role. Like if they remake Dirty Dancing, yes, Harry should be in it. If they ever remake Rocky Horror, the Rocky Horror Picture Show, Harry could play every part, but especially I wanted to play Frankenfurter. Harry, please, I need your career to follow James Marsden's, not James Corden's. Well, no, I do want him to follow James Corden's because he's in every movie musical. I need you to replace James Corden in every movie musical. Zac Efron belonged in movie musicals and he's given up on us, but it's not too late for you. Please, 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 please. He thinks he can just put that in a song? You pop when we get intimate. That song should be called Cherry. All right, next we have Daydreaming. Again, if you played me that part, that intro, I would never expect that that's a Harry Styles song. She lives in daydreams with me. I'll be gone for so long. The lyrics, love me like you'll pay me, obviously reminds me of she's all over me, it's like I paid for it, I'm gonna pay for this. But then, you know I'll be gone for so long, give me all your love, give me something to dream about. Just reminds me in Harry Potter when it's Harry's birthday and Ginny doesn't know what to get him and he's about to leave her and go away and find Horcruxes. So she gives him like the sexiest kiss of all time, and if it wasn't a kid's book it would have been something else to like daydream about while he's gone. That is such a good song. I've just discovered something that's not right. I just saw in the credits on Genius that who was playing electric guitar in that song? Mr. John Mayer himself. Harry put John Mayer on his album, so Speak Now is next, confirmed. Next we have Keep Driving. Black and white film camera, yellow sunglasses. This sounds kind of like a Beatles song, which I love. Now, do I need to say it? A song about driving. I don't know. A song about driving and having problems. with said driving. You said it, not me. I just hope whatever happens in this song when he's driving, he doesn't end up with 20 stitches in the hospital room again. Should we just keep driving? Why do I kind of feel like I'm at like a Hawaiian dinner and they're like playing this vibey tropical music? Maple lattes. Pancake. I would ask, should we just keep driving? Driving. Driving. Passports and footwells. Kiss her and don't tell. Wine glass. That I'm three lines in. This is already such a Taylor bridge. I'm sorry I tried to go this whole video without mentioning her, but it's a song about driving. I had to, obviously my mind went there. But this kind of stream of consciousness, list making kind of bridge, he learned from the best. What? Of everything I thought he might sing about on this album, I did not see side boob coming. That's poetry. Please, someone make that your next Instagram caption and tag me so I can like it. Cocaine and side boob. Cocaine and side boob. Joker will deceive you. He just did that. He just sang about choking, right? We all heard that. Okay. I'm just imagining Anne or like Gemma hearing this album, like at the listening party, and he's like, this is the part where I sing about choking her with the sea view. I don't know how to recover from that. I don't know how to just keep going as if I didn't just hear Harry Styles singing about choking. This is the best day of my life. Should we just keep driving? Should we just keep driving? Oh, I love an echo. He knew how much I missed the baby, look what you've done. Okay, so Genius says, keep driving is about getting on with your life and trying to move past all the crazy stuff in the world, going about your day despite everything falling to pieces. Can't relate to that at all. I don't think any of us can relate to that. Mitch did drums and electric guitar on this song. That makes me really happy. And Sarah on the percush. Love to see it. Next we have Satellite. Satellite is right. I feel like I'm in space. Reminds me of something we talked about in a video on this channel. I think it was a girl talk as well, but I spoke about, you know, there's ghosting when someone just completely vanishes from your life, but there's also like orbiting or satelliting where they kind of just stay in the perimeter, or you stay in their perimeter of their life, not interfering and not overlapping, but just sort of still ever present. And I'm wondering if that's what this song is about. Okay, there's nothing for this song, so that's how I'm interpreting it, especially the line spinning out waiting for you to pull me in. If I feel like if you're orbiting someone's life, you kind of, you're stuck in their gravity, but you can only make contact when it's like from them, like they need to initiate it. If I can find the video, I'll link it down below where I talked about that. But wow, I love this. Love that guitar. Again, I feel like his last album was very funk, very pop, almost larger than life. This song to me, the word I keep coming back to, even though it's like a cringy word, is like vibes. Like it's just a vibey song. I just want to put this on all the time, especially while I'm drinking wine. I'm in an LA mood. I don't want to talk to you. She said, give me a day or two. An LA mood is like partying, like not wanting to sort of connect on a deeper level, I suppose. Satellite. That little run of his voice. Song is like one of the most relatable on the album so far. I feel like everyone has that person, whether it's a friendship or a crush or whatever, and you're just on the outside. This is basically You Belong With Me by Taylor Swift. You can see them and you're like, aren't you lonely? Like, don't you want to pull me in? I could be a great part of your life. This live with those guitars and drums and the echoing of his voice. I'm so jealous of everyone that's going to One Night Only. Even the production on this album. It's so good. I mean, it's always good, but like, it's just so different, which I love and I'm so proud of him for, because those little bits that you just heard, like, that doesn't feel like anything I've heard from Harry before, and I love it. And I feel like the show Spinning Out, if that's still a thing, they should use this on their next season. Was so beautiful. That was like a church choir melody of angels singing to us. Thank you, Harry. All right, next we have Boyfriends. To boyfriends everywhere, fuck you. So he's speaking backwards, right? That's, I'm not having a stroke. I feel like I'm watching Spy Kids hearing Floop is a madman, help us, save us backwards. What did he just say? Fool, you're back at it again.
Back at it again with the white bands.
Sunflower Volume 6 vibes. Love to hear it. I'm gonna try and let this whole song just play because it is just so beautiful. I don't want to interrupt.
Boyfriends, they think you're so easy.
I know I said I wouldn't interrupt. I just feel like this song is the perfect campfire song. I want him to sit around under a canyon moon with a little guitar, but I don't want him to be the kind of guy that sings and plays guitar to like serenade you. But I feel like this song deserves that treatment, so I'll allow it just this once.
He starts secretly drinking,
it gets hard to know what he's thinking. Are you thinking the same as I am? For those of you that know Half the World Away, I've definitely spoken about that on this channel before, and I've started drinking, I don't know half of what I'm thinking. I love when artists not recycle, but like have a phrase or a message, or I guess a like passage of writing that like sits with them and they use it more than once. That just reminded me of that.
Why you don't know?
His voice.
Boyfriends.
I love when a song includes like the raw instruments, just, I mean, it's all instruments obviously playing from the studio, but when the person's just kind of trailing out at the end, when they leave that in, it feels really nice. I feel like we should take this opportunity, as we've been singing about boyfriends, to have a quick reminder. I see a lot of stuff online that is, I would call, invalidating. People can have boyfriends and they can have girlfriends, and that doesn't detract from each other. That doesn't make one real or not real. That doesn't contradict. People can have both. I just feel like that's not really understood enough in a lot of society. Yeah, you guys know what I mean, right? I just see a lot of invalidation, whether that is with Taylor Swift fans or Harry Styles fans, and it's just frustrating, I guess. I just feel bad for anyone that has to witness other people thinking like that, because there's so many people in the world you can love, and if people don't want to put a label on it, they don't need to, and you shouldn't feel the need to put a label on them. Love is love. Let people love who they love, and let people write music about their love. Let's just enjoy it. I just feel so grateful, especially with this album. I mean, a lot of my favorite albums, but this one now included, it feels so vulnerable and open. It feels like I'm reading Harry's diary, and to expose yourself in that way is obviously so scary and so terrifying, and I think that's how you make great music and great art in general. But I think in return, what we can give back is that same level of respect and understanding and kindness. Love is love. Labels are not necessary if they don't want them. I think that's pretty much everything I needed to say. All right, cool. Now we are up to the last song, which, I mean, could not be more fitting. It is called Love of My Life. I'm not going to look at any of the lyrics. Let's just go into it. Fast or slow? Fast? Feels like it's going to be a fast song.
Baby, you're the love of my life. You don't know it's lost till you find.
Gonna be honest, I thought this track was gonna be a fine line. Well, maybe it will be a fine line. I thought it was gonna be a really slow song. This feels like it's gonna build and build to something grand, and I'm ready for it.
We don't really like what's on the news, but it's on all the time. In a hotel using someone else's name. I remember back at Johnny's place, not the same.
Who's Johnny? I always love hearing about which pseudonyms or like fake names celebrities use when they stay at hotels. I think they're so funny. That just makes me want to listen to Perfect by One Direction.
Baby, you're the love of my life.
having this song written about you. How would you go on living life after that?
You don't know what's lost till you find. Are you lying when you fly?
Oh, frick.
Just coordinates.
Is he saying they broke up because of distance? I'm gonna need a minute. This suddenly feels so intimate. Again, like I said before, it feels like I'm reading his diary.
I don't know you half as well as all my friends. I won't pretend that I've been doing everything I can. Baby, you don't know it's lost till you find it. It's not what I wanted to leave you behind. Baby, you were the love of my life.
We've heard that, right? I appreciate you trying to pick me up, but now is not the time. Oh my god. That last song, that felt so emotionally naked, and like it is just beautiful that Harry is in a place now where he feels comfortable to release music like that. Oh my goodness. It's one of those songs that like makes me think, well, makes me feel things. And he is being so raw and vulnerable that you have no choice but to feel them as well. I'm just so proud of him. And I feel like he's proud of himself. I hope so. I just got a notification that Ben Platt and Sarah Bareilles' song has come out. I'm not even emotionally ready for that at all. I need Harry to go on Hot Ones. Sean, I know you're watching this. Please make it happen. I think he would be the most fantastic guest, and I would love to see him sweat it out while you ask him those amazing, insightful questions. Thank you. I watched the Zane Lowe interview just this morning, and he said something about how, you know, doing the thing that is terrifying and makes you feel absolutely sick, just like sick to your stomach with fear and with terror, is the thing that is the most rewarding. And it reminds me of a quote that I always loved was, do the thing that scares you. And I feel like that's what he's done in this album. It is so emotionally bare. I think he said being uncomfortable with something doesn't mean it's bad. And it's just that little feeling. And that's something I try and remind myself, because I get quite bad anxiety. And I try and remind myself that excitement and anxiety or fear or stress feel the same in your body, right? It's the same like nervous system response. And so it's then up to your mind to pick which it is that you feel, whether it's fear and nerves or it's excitement. And I try to go towards excitement, and it is so hard, but I feel like that is when we create the most beautiful things, whether that is connection or art or a fantastic album. Doing the thing that scares you usually has the most rewarding outcome. I don't know what to do with myself now, besides listen to this album on repeat. I would love to hear from you guys which your favorites are, and like maybe if you have a skip. I don't think I have a skip from that whole album. I enjoyed every single second of that, as you can probably tell. I think it's too soon for me to say my favorites, but I will definitely share them on Instagram. I took some really fun photos this morning as well, and you can see those on there. Here's a little sneak preview, but I can't wait to talk to you guys about this. I love the community that comes from music and sharing music and talking about music. It feels like we're just like best friends at a bar or around a campfire, in fact, sharing our opinions and kind of baring our souls a little bit when we express like which songs we connect with. Yeah, at a quick glance, I think I could say that Matilda hit me pretty hard. I loved that song. Anyway, I'm gonna go because it's getting late and I need to drink some water to make up for all of this. Before we go, I have to do the whole YouTube thing. So if you like this video and want to see my face again, make sure you are subscribed and hit the bell. Give this video a big thumbs up. It helps me out so much. And I will see you guys next time. I love you all so much. Bye.